Hello friends, we have already studied the layout of the thermal power plant. We know that in case of thermal power plant, coal is used as the source for boiling the water, which eventually gets converted into steam. This steam is operated on the turbine. So the turbine is coupled to the generator and the electrical energy is generated. So in this video, we are going to study about the coal handling plant. Now the coal handling plant can be divided into three various sections, such as first is unloading plant, that is wagon tripper. So in case of unloading plant, the coal reaches the main site from the various areas or from the coal mines. So that coal needs to be unloaded. So unloading of coal is done by the unloading plant. Next is conveying plant, for conveying of the coal from the unloading to the coal yard. And third is crushing plant. This is required for crushing the coal in the required size. So the standard size for the coal is required to be 19 mm or less than 19 mm. The coal which is having the size above 19 mm needs to be crushed. So the coal that is available is not uniformly in the size. So in order to get the coal in the required size, the crushing of coal needs to be done. Now let us see each of these sections in detail. So first we will study about the unloading plant. Now the coal is brought to the power station from the particular site by the rail or by the train. Now about 6 to 8 wagons are placed in the wagon marshalling area by the means of a shunter. Now each wagon is adjusted on the tipper platform in the proper section. The wagon tipper tilts the wagon and unloads the coal into the hopper. The coal from the hopper is fed to the conveyors A and B by the means of electric vibrating feeders. Now figure A shows the schematic arrangements of the coal handling plant. So let us study it in detail. So here we can see the schematic arrangement of the coal handling plants. Now it consists of number of belts such as 1A, 1B, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So these various belts are used for the various purposes. So here we can see that the coal which is coming from the rail or any other transportation needs to be unloaded. So these are the various hoppers. So by using the belts 1A and 1B, the unloading of the coal is done. Next, let us study about the conveying plant. So once the coal is unloaded, by using the conveying belts, it is passed further. Now the conveying plant consists of conveyor belts of 1A, 1B, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now belt number 4 can be rotated in either direction while the others have only one direction. So let us see the belt number 4 in the diagram. So this is the belt number 4. It can be rotated in either direction. All the remaining belts have only one direction. Now the coal from belt number 1A or 1B is taken by belt number 2 to the vibrating screens and then to the crushers. Let us see this in the diagram. So we can see here the coal from the belt 1 and 2 are given on belt number 2. From here, it is given to the screens and from screens it is given to the crushers. Now the crushed coal from the crusher and the small size of coal from the screen falls on belt number 4. Now this process is reversible. With the direct bunkering, the coal falls on belt number 5, while the stocking, the coal falls on belt number 3. Now this belt is a revolving with the telescopic hopper and is run when the coal is to be stored in the outside station yard. With the direct bunkering, coal falls from belt number 4 to belt number 5, which takes the coal to the tipper and then boiler bunkers. On the conveyor number 6, two controls are provided for filling the coal into the bunkers, one for each unit. Now on the various belts, the magnetic separators are also provided in order to remove any magnetic material such as bolts, iron scraps, etc., which might be present in the coal. So the coal needs to be cleaned. This type of coal has to be put into the crusher. So while the coal is put into the crusher, there should not be any magnetic material present in the coal. Now this is done so that it does not go into the crusher and also into the bunkers for their final stage. Now let us study about the crushing plant. So the screens are provided to reduce the load on the crusher. The coal size of 19 mm and below passes through it and the remaining coal goes in the crusher. So the standard size for the coal is 19 mm or below 19 mm. If the coal size is above 19 mm, then it needs to be crushed. Now vibrating equipment is provided with the screen. Now the coal of the size which is larger than the 19 mm is crushed inside the crusher. Now the crusher is coupled to the motor through a fluid coupling so that there is no sudden pressure on the motor due to failure of the coupling for control of the speed or output shaft as may be required depending upon the load on the crusher. Now the capacity of bunkers should be enough to feed to the boilers for at least 8 hours on the full load. So the coal which is crushed finally goes to the boilers. So the capacity should be such that it should feed 8 hours in a day. Now knowing the requirements of the boiler, it is for the 24 hours, the capacity of the crusher and the coal conveying plant size can be worked out. So depending upon the capacity of the boiler, the capacity of the crusher and the coal conveying plant must be decided. Now if the coal is received faster than required, it is stored in the yard. And if the rate is low, then the coal from the yard can be used in order to make up for the deficit. So the above description of the coal handling plant arrangements are for the very large steam power plant or for the very large steam turbine. If the station is located near to the coal pit, then the transport cost by the rail is reduced. But mostly this is not possible in all the cases. The plant can be located far away from the coal pit. So the transportation charges will be added. Now if a coal mine is very near, sometimes aerial ropeways are used to take coal in to the station. So the arrangement of the belts may differ, but the principle used for each and every is same. So in this way, we have studied the layout of coal handling plant. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda. Thank you.